Hi and welcome to Hari to Fitness. In this episode, what we are going to see is how much personal training charges I can pay for my trainer. So in this pandemic situation, most of the people are opting at home personal training services. So here I have lots of conflicts in the pricing of a personal trainer service. It's like sometimes it's like the client feels the trainer is charging more. Sometimes the trainer feels I'm charging less. So to put an end, it's like I would like to give some kind of a suggestions on this. Before getting into that, who am I to give those suggestions? What's my eligibility? I'm Hari. It's like I run a fitness academy called ACFIT Academy for fitness professionals for past 7 years. It's like I had certified more than 2,000 fitness trainers all over India through online and offline training. I had traveled all over the country and met various personal trainers and fitness trainers, so I'm able to provide a right suggestion for this problem. So basically, to understand that, we need to classify the personal training service into three main categories. One is at-home personal training, two is your online personal training, three is your personal training at your facility, maybe at your gym or your personal training studio. Let's look at-home personal training charges. There is a minimal charge, something like there are some trainers who can opt their service for 3,000 per month. There are some trainers who charge 30,000, sometimes 3 lakhs also. So we leave these both the extremes apart. Let's look at the average part of it. The average at home personal training somewhere lies in between 8,000 to 15,000. Now the question is, for which trainer I can pay 8,000 and which trainer I can pay 15,000? It's like, to understand this, we need to evaluate the trainer with three major criteria. Number one, experience. How long he been to fitness industry? Maybe based on the number of years he is experienced, his charges might be high. Second thing is credibility. Credibility is what kind of results he bring to his clients. Is he is doing an injury-free training? Maybe you can talk to his existing clients and to get an idea about that. Sometimes he might be referred through your existing clients. So these two are very important aspects to find the credibility. Most people think if the fitness trainer is training a celebrity or if he is a bodybuilder or some kind of an athlete, they think that is a very important aspect of credibility. That is only one aspect of credibility. Very important aspect is he is doing an injury-free training and what kind of results he brings to his client. That's a very important aspect you need to consider. The third thing is knowledge. Is your fitness trainer is certified? Does he has a proper CPR AED certification? See, most of the fitness trainers don't do any kind of a proper, even I can say it's like they don't do the CPI, they don't renew their CPI AED. That's a very, very mandatory requirement for a fitness trainers to handle any kind of medical emergency which happens when he is training. So you need to evaluate your trainer based on these criterias. You can't opt a trainer who has experience, proper credibility and proper certification for a very low cost. So it's pretty tough to bargain with that type of trainer. So somebody who is new, he got a certification, a less experience, you are able to get a personal training service in low price. I think this video has given a clear idea about how much charges you can pay for your personal training client at home PT. I would like to make a separate video for online personal training and personal training service at gym. Thanks for watching.